Okay, so let's continue with the class. And as Sharvari asked very important questions. Fine. So let us see what these groups are and how do they behave. Okay, so first of all, can you all show any alkali metals? Let's start with the first one. Alkali metal.
Beryllium.
Calcium.
No, no, that is beryllium is alkaline. Right? Alkali is group which has lithium. No, no, no. Lithium ke saath kaun kaun hai? All of you can join in and show the cards which are, what do you say, alkali metals. Any alkali metal?
How to know that, bhai?
Look at the cards, no?
Alkali.
Lithium ke group mein
kaun kaun hai? Potassium.
Yes, potassium. Very good. Yeah.
Beryllium.
Same.
No, magnesium is not alkali.
Beryllium. Beryllium. Beryllium.
It's an alkaline earth metal. That's the second group. Just look for the
calcium. Kind of configuration. Calcium.
2-1 wala. No, no, no. Not calcium.
Sodium.
Yes, sodium. Can you pick all the three together? Lithium, sodium, and potassium. Can all of you have all the three cards together? Sharvari, you can also, Sharvari and Sunny also, please start your video. So that I'm like sure that you have got all the elements together. Okay, lithium.
Cards together?
Yeah, sodium and potassium.
Sodium, potassium.
Lithium, sodium and potassium.
Potassium, huh? Lithium.
कैल्शियम भी है ना भैया
नहीं नहीं कैल्शियम नहीं आएगा पहले ये तीन निकालो ना ओके शर्वरी यू कैन आल्सो शो योर ऑल द थ्री कार्ड्स
कौन कौन सा भैया
देखो ना जिसके बाहर एक ही इलेक्ट्रॉन है लिथियम सोडियम पोटेशियम Okay, so they three form a group together. You're getting it? Mil gaye tino?
Yes, okay, bhaiya.
Okay, so these three are alkali metals. Okay. Alkali metals, that's because when you put that in water, it makes the solution alkaline. Okay, so these are alkali metals and these are very much soluble in water. Okay, that means you put that in water, it gets dissolved. That's it. You cannot keep them, what do you say, in pure form at all. Okay, so these are the alkali metals.
Potassium.
Yes, very good. Yeah, Sharvari. So, Sunny, can you also show all the three?
But yeah.
Huh. Yeah. Your Tejasri is getting disconnected. No problem. Okay, so these are the alkali metals. Is it clear? And what is there in common?
We cannot.
Yeah.
So Miss Maya, we cannot use it in pure.
It's not at all. Like you can use it, not that way, but in common atmosphere, or if there is water, then it won't stay as it is. It will react very quickly. Okay. What will happen? It will react to give hydroxides. Okay, sodium hydroxide, lithium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide. Okay, you will come to know about that. But the thing is, very reactive, behaves the same way, and it can explode in water. So today I will share a video of what happens when you put this pure metal in water. Okay, it causes a big explosion. Okay, so that is your alkali metals. So what is in common? They just have one electron outside. Okay, just one electron in the outer shell.
Yes.
And it can quickly give that electron away. And since it can quickly give that electron away and become very stable, it releases a lot of energy, lot of heat energy. Okay, so whenever something is becoming stable, it means it is releasing a lot of heat energy. And if it's releasing a lot of heat energy, that means it is getting stable in a way. So they both are behaving in the same way. So that's your group of alkali metals. Please remember them together. Lithium, sodium and potassium. Okay. So next, let us start with the next group of beryllium, magnesium and calcium. Pick those three out.
Beryllium, magnesium
and calcium.
Done.
Ready?
Yeah, magnesium, magnesium.
12 number. Okay, so these are beryllium, magnesium and calcium. Can you tell what is common in all the three? Yeah, can you show close to the camera so that it's clear for everyone?
Yeah, outer shell has two electrons.
Very good. Yes, outer shell has two electrons. And it can give two electrons. All the three can give two electrons. But what happens is that these metals and their hydroxides are not very much soluble in water. That's why it's called as alkaline earth metals, because they are found on earth. Okay, all the marbles, they contain this metal, calcium and magnesium. Okay, limestone, you see that white stones, right? Limestone, they contain magnesium and calcium. Since they are found on the earth's crust, these are known as alkaline earth metals. That means they prefer to be in solid state. That means, yes, they are soluble in water, but not fully soluble in water. They precipitate out in the form of hydroxides. Okay, yani ki wo solid banke bahar nikal jayega pani ke. Aur safed safed aapko dikhta hai na, kabhi pipe mein bhi aapne dekha hoga, white color ka. So these are all known as alkaline earth metal. Most common thing you can find it in a paan wala shop. Wo chuna hota hai na, that you get for 1 rupee, you can get one chuna ka pouch. So that is calcium hydroxide. Okay, our teeth, this is calcium. Okay, so in a way, these three elements, what they do, unke paas bahar do electron hai, ye do electron de sakta hai. Okay, so these three can give two electrons, and that's why they are known as alkaline earth metals. They always give two electrons. Okay, so understood? This is one group. Okay, so now let's move on to the other side of the periodic table. Take out fluorine, chlorine and bromine.
Fluorine, chlorine and bromine. Huh?
Yeah. What do you see there?
Takes one electron.
What it does?
Yes.
Takes one electron.
Takes one electron.
Just a second. Just fine.
Yes.
Chlorine. Okay. I don't know where I.
Bhaiya, fluorine, chlorine, and
bromine.
Bromine.
Okay, I'm not finding it. It's okay. Fluorine, chlorine, and bromine. Okay, so fluorine, chlorine and bromine, they together, what they do, they can take one electron. But if you see bromine, what does it tell? That it can share 7 electron to fluorine and oxygen. Okay, they are all halogens. They all three are known as halogens. Okay, just to keep in mind, they three are halogens. They generally take one electron. But if you see, which is smaller in size? Fluorine is smaller or bromine is smaller?
Fluorine.
Fluorine, right?
Fluorine.
So anything that is small has the capacity to pull electron towards it. Okay. Since fluorine is smaller, it can pull electron towards it. So what happens? It can pull electron from chlorine and bromine also. Okay. It can pull electron from other elements also. Okay, the smaller the element, the more it can pull. Okay, so now let's look at the other three, oxygen, sulfur and selenium. The next one that will be just to the, what do you say, left of that group. Okay, these are the, they are called as chalcogens, oxygen, sulfur and selenium.
Oxygen, sulfur and selenium.
So they three all belong to the same group. Ye three can take one electron, take two electrons, sorry. Ye tino do electron le sakte hain. Okay. Oxygen, sulfur and selenium. Again, what happens when you see here, compare with oxygen and let's take sulfur, which is bigger and which is smaller?
Oxygen is smaller.
Oxygen is smaller than sulfur. That means oxygen can take electron from sulfur also. Okay, it can take 6 electrons from sulfur. Right? That means it can make sulfur share its outer electrons also, because oxygen wants more electrons. Okay, so in an atmosphere where oxygen is more, what will happen? Sulfur has to share its electron with oxygen also. Okay, so instead of oxygen only taking 2 electrons, it has to also share its electron. Okay, because oxygen will pull more electrons. Okay, so relatively you have to see what the element will do. Is it clear? Agar sulfur ko koi metal milta hai jo electron de sakta hai, to wo ye gap fill kar lega. Can you see sulfur? If sulfur, yes, gets anything that can give 2 electrons, like magnesium, then it will become magnesium sulfide. Okay, but if it comes across something which can share electrons like oxygen, then it has to share its electrons. Okay, outer electron. Fine. If oxygen comes, it has to share its 6 electrons. Okay, you can see the series of it and make an understanding of that. Okay, so the whole concept is known as electronegativity. So let me see if I get one... Yes, there is an electronegativity chart. Okay. So let me just share the screen. You are able to see this chart? No?
Yes, Paya.
Is it now better?
Huh.
Okay. So just take a look at this chart. Okay, it's very important. Fine. So what you see here is the degree up to which it can pull electrons in a bond. Okay, so suppose there are 2 elements which are going to bond. So if any element has higher electronegativity, it means it will pull more electrons. So let me just compare 2 charts. Okay, so that will clarify this whole concept. Okay, we are moving on to this important concept. Okay, so one is comparison of atomic size. Okay, you are able to see this chart now, atomic size wala chart?
No, bhaiya.
No. You are only seeing the electronegativity chart?
Yeah, now.
Okay. Now is it visible?
Now it is.
Okay, so let me put both the charts in place. And a comparison of both the charts will give a clear result. Okay. Okay, so let me just share this new screen. Okay, so now if you see here, there are two charts to compare. Okay, as we progress in one row, when we move from lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, neon, what is happening is the shell is the same, but inside the charge is increasing, no? This is plus 3, plus 4, plus 5, plus 6, plus 7, plus 8, plus 9, plus 10. The size is going down. Okay, that means there is more charge in the center which is pulling the electron towards itself. Okay, but as we go down, the size is increasing. So can you see here that electronegativity is just the opposite of it? Okay, for a while just forget this part, these elements. Okay, they are not part of chemistry, so I am just removing them. Okay, now if you make a comparison, the elements which are much smaller in size have higher electronegativity. Okay, can you correlate that? Fluorine is the smallest one among the elements and it is having one of the highest electronegativities. Leave hydrogen alone, we will talk about that later, but you can just see this group. Hydrogen is small, but it can also give electrons. So it does not have much electronegativity. Okay, but if you see here, fluorine is among the smallest with highest electronegativity. And other elements with high electronegativity are oxygen, okay, nitrogen, and chlorine. Okay, these four elements have very high electronegativity. Okay, then what happens to sulfur when it reacts with oxygen? Then you just see here. Okay, in a way, what is happening? Sulfur has to give electrons to oxygen. Is it understandable? Right? Sulfur has to now give electrons to oxygen. Okay. Is it clear? Any other element, phosphorus has to give electrons to all the other elements which are more electronegative. Like for example, if we take this, it has to give
electrons. Cl is a chlorine, na?
Chlorine, yeah. Okay, so now what is happening? It has to now give electrons to these elements. Okay, sulfur has to give electrons to these elements. Understood? Phosphorus again have to give electrons instead of being able to take electrons. Is it clear? Can you see the difference here? What electronegativity tells is that at the end of the day, who is going to take the electrons? Okay, so fluorine always will take the electron. Oxygen has to give electron to fluorine, but it can take electron from others. Nitrogen has to share, or in a way give means even share electrons. Okay, so nitrogen has to give or share electrons to oxygen, but it can take electron from others. Okay, now what about phosphorus and sulfur? If you take a metal, like for example calcium or iron, any other metal, you see here that this has to give electrons to even sulfur also. Okay? Or phosphorus also. Understood? Different samajh mein aa raha hai na? Jo niche hai, wo upar ko इलेक्ट्रॉन देगा इन टर्म्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिविटी. ओके, सो इफ यू सी हियर ऑल दिस ग्रुप, ओके, दिस होल ग्रुप ऑफ मेटल्स, दे कैन ओनली गिव इलेक्ट्रॉन्स. ओके, बट इफ यू सी हियर इन दिस, सॉरी आई कैन नॉट मेक अ सर्कल, आई हैव टू यूज अ ब्रश. ओके, सो इफ यू सी दिस ग्रुप इन बिटवीन, दे कैन टेक इलेक्ट्रॉन फ्रॉम हियर, ओके, बट दे हैव टू गिव इलेक्ट्रॉन्स टू दीज पीपल. ओके, एंड द एलिमेंट्स ओवर हियर, एस्पेशली दीज फोर, फ्लोरिन, ऑक्सीजन, नाइट्रोजन एंड क्लोरिन, एंड दे आर द स्मॉलेस्ट अमॉन्ग द एलिमेंट्स इन द पीरियोडिक टेबल. ओके, दे हैव, दे ऑलवेज टेक इलेक्ट्रॉन्स. ओके, सो नाउ डू यू अंडरस्टैंड द डिफरेंस, राइट, हाउ दे बिहेव. ओके, all the elements here, for example, if you further divide, if you see the alkali metals here, they will always give electrons. Okay, here in between we have transition metals which can decide that how much electron they can give and take, and in between you get semi metals has mean they can sometime take electron, they can sometime give electron or share electrons. Okay, and here you get non-metals. These non-metals are such that they can sometimes share electrons or take electrons. And here you see how they will only prefer to take electrons or share electrons only among themselves. Suppose that means there are two oxygen, then there is no way to go. You have to share. There are two fluorine, then you have to share. Okay, but suppose there is nitrogen and oxygen, then there will be sharing, but that will not be equal sharing. Okay, there will be unequal sharing. Okay, so that is the whole concept of relating with atomic size and electronegativity. Okay, so now you are able to understand why the behavior is different for different things. Okay, so when you see phosphorus, okay, now let us take one card. Like for example, let us take sulfur. Okay, take your time to see what it means let me take it very close. It generally takes or shares two electrons, but can give six electrons to other elements F, O, N and Cl. That means which has higher electronegativity. Okay, that means which has more affinity to pull electrons. And anything which can pull electron more than sulfur has to share the outer electrons with them. So it's all about a game of this negativity. Okay, so we'll further learn more about the concept of electronegativity, but at this point of time, okay, so let's get back to the track, and today we will learn one more game. Okay, and so in this game what you have to do, it's a lot like poker. Okay, now you can play with all the cards. Okay, so I think you can all start with the video and let's do a small round so that you get to like remember the elements in a better way as better groups also. Okay, so let's shuffle the cards. Okay, and you can start the video. Okay, so what you have to do is pick any three cards from the top. Pick any three cards and show it here. Have you anybody played poker on cards with playing cards? You might have heard of the game poker, right?
No, bhaiya. Yes.
Okay, no problem. So yes, okay. Fine. So you have, everybody have taken up three cards. Sunny, show your cards. Yes, fine. Okay. So now, what do you say? Sunny, show your cards as well. Shambhu, you also.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So can you see any pattern in that three?
Okay.
Okay. So one way of seeing a pattern is this. I have two cards of the same group. This is one pattern. Mm-hmm. Okay, boron and gallium belong to the same group. This is one pattern. So those who have a higher form of pattern, a more rare form of pattern, will win the game.
Okay,
so what is the cards that Sunny has? Selenium, chlorine and... Yes, Sunny has won the round, if you see. Chlorine and selenium. So Sunny also has a pattern of pair. Okay, there's a pair pattern. Okay. And just the two of us have a pattern. Shamvi almost have a pattern. Like it could have been three transition metals. Okay. Fine. So it's about finding the pattern.
Selenium, fluorine.
So selenium ka dusra group hai na. Same group ke the best pattern is, I'll just show you the best possible pattern. And that is this. Okay, three noble metals. So if you get three noble metals, you get the highest point. Okay, so this is like a gambling game in a way. Okay, so you try to bet on getting the best pair of three cards. Okay, it's like three aces. Okay, three noble metals is like three aces. Okay, so other three element can be anything of three of the same type. Sulfur, selenium, oxygen, sulfur, selenium. Okay, so this is again a pair of three. Okay. Fine. So, like this, yes, any doubt?
No, bhaiya.
Okay. So, this is again one pair. Three, pair of three. Okay. So, what we can do is to make the game more interesting. Let us pick five cards. Okay, just shuffle again. Vivek, you can also come with your video on. Sunny, aapka shayad ye ho gaya. Just once, can you stop the video and again come? Stuck ho gaya. Okay, shuffle. And you can pick five cards.
Aaya bhai.
Haan, paanch card uthao. Theek hai? Show all the five cards. Fine. And now select the best of three in which you see a pattern, or eliminate two cards which you think that it's not important. Okay. So just take a look at what, let play one after the other. Okay. For example, now I have these five cards. Okay. So I am removing fluorine number 9. Okay. And I'm removing, let me remove chromium 24. So what I have is three transition metals. Okay, so I have a nice pair here. Nice triad here. Three transition metals together. Okay, or three D block elements. So, manganese, iron and zinc. Okay, so they all belong to the same, what do you say? They all belong to one category of D block elements. Okay, so 21 to 30 becomes a group. So you also pick five cards. Okay. Then show me the five cards that you choose and eliminate the two. So Tejasri, can you name out all the five cards?
Krypton, helium, neon, and chlorine and zinc.
Okay.
So I'm removing chlorine and zinc, and these three are same.
Very good. Okay. So Tejasri has the three top cards. And so Shambhavi, give it a try. Vivek, aap bhi try karo. Panch card aap select karo. Aur usme se aap dhundo ki kaun sa teen same group mein aata hai.
Main bolu main?
Haan, batao. Sunny, dikha. Card dikha to yaar.
Ye. Dikhne.
Okay, good.
Sodium, magnesium, calcium.
Nahin, sodium, magnesium, calcium same group mein nahi hai. Sodium dusra group mein. कलर थोड़ा सेम लग सकता है बट ग्रुप अलग है उसका है ना और क्या क्या कार्ड है
बोरॉन सल्फर
ओके सो मैग्नीशियम कैल्शियम तो का आपका एक पेयर बन गया. ओके सो व्हाट आई हैव इज अ थ्री ट्रांजिशन मेटल्स. ओके व्हाट तेजश्री हैज इज द टॉप कार्ड. ओके थ्री नोबल मेटल्स. ओके सनी यू हैव अ पेयर, आपके पास एक पेयर है ना, कैल्शियम एंड मैग्नीशियम. ओके यू कैन पिक एनी अदर कार्ड. ओके यस एंड व्हाट शांभवी हैज इज अ पेयर. कैन यू सी, कैन यू टेल हाउ यू एलिमिनेटेड द अदर कार्ड्स शांभवी, व्हाट ऑल द फाइव कार्ड्स यू हैव एंड व्हाट यू एलिमिनेटेड.
I had boron, carbon, bromine, silicon, and fluorine.
Okay, so you chose fluorine,
carbon, and boron.
Okay, so in a way you also had a pair, no? Carbon, silicon, yeah, but you chose a higher pair, right? No problem. So the pair that you chose is, can you show that again? The three cards that you choose. Okay, fluorine, bromine is a pair. Yes. Okay, and you have taken silicon. No problem. So you also have a pair. Okay, so those who have a trinity have 3 points in a way. You can just have a scoring system accordingly. And those who have a pair have 2 points. Okay, Vivek, aap 5 cards select karo koi bhi.
Yeah, bhaiya, mereko 3 mile.
Oh, very good. Dekho, okay, again there's a confusion. Aap log color dekh ke bata rahe ho na, keval?
नहीं भैया, इन तीनों का ग्रुप मेटल है.
नहीं लेकिन कैल्शियम का ग्रुप अलग है ना. यू ऑल्सो हैव अ पेयर एक्चुअली, नॉट अ प्रॉब्लम. शर्वरी
भैया आप मेडिसिन ले.
यस ओके प्ले अनदर राउंड ऑफ, नो प्रॉब्लम. लेट्स प्ले वन मोर राउंड ऑफ दिस शफल अगेन. विवेक आप अपना बता सकते
हैं. देखो मैं बताऊं. मैं
हां बता.
नहीं 6 उठा लिया. रुको ये जिंक, वेनेडियम,
यस,
टाइटेनियम.
टाइटेनियम वेरी गुड. साथ में बस नंबर याद रखना उनके, है ना, जिंक का नंबर साथ में नंबर भी बताना ताकि याद रहे. ओके विवेक
एटॉमिक नंबर.
हाँ एटॉमिक नंबर साथ में याद रखो, ठीक है. कॉन्फ़िगरेशन सब पूरा एक बार, जो भी कार्ड उठता है ना उसको पूरा एक बार देख लो क्या क्या है उसमें क्या लिखा है, कि बार बार वो उठाते उठाते फिर अपने को याद हो जाएगा, ठीक है. सो लेट्स लेट मी आल्सो जस्ट पिक टॉप 5 कार्ड्स. ओके तेजश्री यू हैव चोजन.
मेरा ग्रुप 5 ग्रुप 4 के.
ग्रुप 5 ग्रुप 4 में आपको ये नहीं मिलेगा ज्यादा, क्योंकि उसके केवल एक एक एलिमेंट है अभी.
आई गॉट पेयर.
ओके यू गॉट अ पेयर, गुड. Okay, I too got the two pairs.
Are we supposed to match the period or the group?
See, it's better to match the group because they make the same type of chemical reactions, right? So I too got, if you see, two pairs. Okay, so I am eliminating nickel out.
Helium or zinc same aate kya?
Nahi. Okay, so I have a pair of noble gases, argon and helium. Okay.
Bhaiya, I got sodium, lithium and potassium.
But we cannot believe you unless you.
Okay. Wait a second, it's something problem with setting, bhaiya.
Okay, just see if you can participate in the video. Vivek, aap bhi kholo yaar, 3 card aap open karo, 5 mein se. Yes. Oh, very good. So now Shravari got the 3 of the same group. ओके
भैया मेरे को तो ही मिल रहे
हैं. या शर्वरी यू आर सिस्टर.